Well, sports can often serve as an escape for some people, but they quickly take a backseat when real life takes over. Tonight, we observe a moment of silence for the tragic events in Quebec City on Sunday night. Here's PA announcer Michel Lacroix.
C'est avec un sentiment d'indignation et de tristesse que la grande famille des Canadiens a appris la triste nouvelle des événements survenus dimanche à Québec. Fans, it is with great sadness that the Canadiens organization learned of the tragic events that occurred on Sunday in Quebec City. Please join us in a moment of silence in memory of the victims. Mesdames, Messieurs, observons un moment de silence à la mémoire des victimes.
Now it's Taylor Fadun trying to move it, but Brian Chiantas on it, and he'll backhand it out. Greg Patterson trying to hold off of Evander Kane, does a good job. Kane alone in front, stopped by Price, got a piece of it with a glove. Carey Price with a big stop here in the first period to keep the game scoreless. Wrapped around the boards, Radulov will pick it off. Here's Radulov, back to the line, Patterson fires, stopped by Leonard, rebound in front. Just got the pad back as Radulov tried to sneak it in.
Good shots from the point. He gets another nice one off here. Gets to the middle, lets that shot go, and the rebound is going to squirt right out to Radulov, and Leonard just somehow gets that leg across.
Michael in over the line, feeds it down low. Foligno dropped it back, but it's intercepted, and Pacioretty's on it. Up ahead for Alexander Radulov. Radulov cutting in, the Pacioretty scores! Pacioretty finishes off the play for his 22nd of the season.
Great finish from Pacioretty, who elevates that up and over Robin Leonard. But Radulov, just such an excellent passer, and especially on the backhand. We've seen this so many times from Radulov. He's able to make plays at top speed and on the backhand. Beautiful pass and an excellent finish from Max Pacioretty.
Philippe Deneau rolls it off the boards, down the wing, trying to go after it. Reinhardt there as well, played it back, but it's Foligno, the interception now grabbed by Deneau, right in front, Pacioretty scores! Alexander Radulov sets up the captain again for his second of the night, and it's 2-0.
Now what a release off the stick of Max Pacioretty. Turnover down low, Radulov with the initial forecheck. And there's Deneau over to Radulov, the quick pass. And that's the key. Radulov does not waste any time getting this puck. He one times it, gets it quickly to the stick of Pacioretty, which allows Pacioretty more time to shoot that puck and doesn't allow Robin Leonard to set himself. He's to lose pucks, and that's a, for a skilled player to be playing like that, unbelievable.
Branson turned it over, Andrew Geno to David Dernay, scores! David Dernay, back after missing 24 games, finds the back of the net, and it's 3-0 Montreal.
Bogosian has that puck, he puts it over to Cody Franz, and just tape to tape, turnover, ends up coming on the stick of David Dernay. And Dernay steps to the middle, all kinds of time to release that shot, and a great pass from Andrew Geno. An awful giveaway from Cody Franz, and a great read, almost like you're a defensive back. Andrew Geno with the pick, and sets up David Dernay.
With it now, Zach Bogosian is on it. Hands it off for Franson. Played up ahead, went off the leg of Oposo and knocked him down. Here's Plekanec sending it over right in front, of Byron scores! Andre Markov with a nice feed, and Byron finishes the job to make it 4-0.
And Montreal's been getting better and better as this game has moved along. And again, the Buffalo Sabres, they have control. Puck gets turned over and inside the zone. Great little pass right to the stick of Paul Byron. And Plekanec goes over. Right back to Byron, and a great quick finish by Paul.
Hit a body in front, I believe it caught Justin Falk. Sabres don't get it out though. Radulov back on it, dancing in. He'll take it back in the net, holds on to the puck. Radulov with a chance, shot got blocked. Pacioretty scores! Pacioretty win the hat trick, and it's 5-0 Montreal.
And this big number one line for the Canadiens been having their way with the Sabres, and Radulov again, the strength on the puck and the patience as he holds onto the puck, comes out of the corner, throws it towards Robin Lehner, and right in front of the net, Danault knocks Lehner, I think just a little bit off balance, and right after, Pacioretty's going to shoot the puck, there's Danault, he gets pushed in to Lehner. Lehner slides out of the way, and Pacioretty's there to deposit that puck right by Robin Lehner. There's a little push in the crease, and that leaves just enough room for Max Pacioretty to shoot that puck. And the Hats now all over the ice here in Montreal.
In front of him just did a terrible job, especially in that second period, clearing the front of the net and giving him any type of help.
Kulikov scores, and the shutout bid is gone, and Kulikov picks up his first. He will say, finally, as a Buffalo Sabre.
Now this is just right from the faceoff. Draw's gonna go straight back. Kulikov just waits no time, pulls it into the middle, takes the fast shot. I'm not sure. Matt Molson is in the middle of the ice. Let's see if he touches that at all. If not, it really doesn't matter to this point. The puck's in the net. And well, you're right, it breaks the shutout, but it is something positive the Sabres can take out.
Thinks it's a great event.
Well, I might have to start drinking again after this one here tonight. Just to
have a nice team for you on the bus. Sabres go to work here in front. Here's a chance. Gianta scores! His string of points in Montreal continues. And the Sabres get their second of the game with 2:12 to go. It's 5-2.
Now, we talked about being in a situation where you had to try to develop some positives, and this is exactly what they've been able to do here with the Kulikov goal. Now on the power play, this puck is going to be worked to the point by Matt Molson, gets it across. The shot's going to come from the point. And Brian Johnson just got himself planted in front. That's Cody Fronson is the one who gets the puck to the front of the net. The save's made by Price. Brian Johnson, nobody touches him until the last second. He's able to get the puck from his backhand to his forehand and just slide it by Price, who is stuck out on the top right corner of the crease.